Good morning, guys. How's it going? It's the it's a Riverfest match on Bridgnorth. Talking to a couple of lads, the first time they fish it. So I've only fished it three times, so that's good in a way. At least I don't know the pegs, and I'm you know, going to be optimistic on the draw. So anyway, just waiting for the draw now in a minute.
Oh, the wood bridge.
Right, listen up. When you go up the track, those that are going up the track, take your time.
Really?
It is deep rutted, there's big puddles of water on there, nice and steady. Some of the pegs up there are a bit steep. It is wet, it is sticky. Be careful going down, it's a natural venue. So take your time climbing down. Fish baller.
You don't want to float the river.
Three zones. That's it. Enjoy your day. 11-4.
If you don't sign on the board before you leave,
sign your name on the board or we won't come looking for you.
I am not spending 2 hours trying to find your name on that list and driving my little car up that
track. Have you got rid of your scooter?
Yeah.
I don't know where I can get drawn. 185.
Tonka.
Where's 200?
Where's 200? Have you drawn it?
Okay, there you are. I've drawn 185. Apparently, it's neither here nor there, really. 200 the end peg is the one. And I was talking to the lad just now, and he just went in before me, and he took the number out. Never mind. There's always a small section to go for. We'll see anyway. Let's enjoy the day and catch what we can. Okay, I'll see you down on the peg. As I say, I've never fished here before. I haven't got a clue, so we'll have a look. Okay, well, bit of a walk, really. Anyway, got you 185. It's on the tree. It's a natural bank. Brian Priest was telling me that somebody had a weight off it once, but looking at the pegs below, look far better. The end peg 200 is the favourite, apparently. But anyway, I got some like a overhanging bushes over there. Seems to be more steady on the inside. It is flowing a little bit. It's very chocolate, so probably be a feeder job, I expect. We'll give it a go though. I'll probably put a light stick in case there's any dace and bleak around. Heavier stick, maybe. I'm not sure the depth, so maybe I'll put a little bulk down as well, and a feeder. Okay, right, let's tackle up. Got plenty of time. Okay, right, lads. Sun's coming out, thank God. Be nice, hopefully. Right, I've just been on the phone to a mate of mine who fishes your regular, and he's saying that there's a few perch to be caught on the inside slack. So that's something I'll have to have a look at. In fact, he said go for them at the beginning, because you'll get a few, and then later on go out and try and catch a barbel or chub. So, you know, I've spoken to Brian Priest as well, a local lad, and he was saying that there's bream along here as well. So, bit of a mixture going on here. So anyway, I'm going to try my best. I'm going to try and keep it simple if I can. You know, the trouble is you've got so many methods and techniques up in your head, like you got to think, well, what's going to be best? Well, looking at it, it's a nice slack, sort of two rod lengths out, and it sort of steadies off and goes down nicely. Further out, it's fast, you know, and it's probably a bit shallower, and that's where the probably chub and the barbel are going to lie. With this bit of dirt in the water, I don't know whether they might feed.
So perhaps they may, perhaps they may not. I mean, I know I'm going to put a fish meal in with pellets for the barbel out and see what happens there. And meat as well, try some meat. So I'm going to cut some meat up in a minute. So at the moment I've got casters, your maggots and your worms. Okay, that's going to be the conventional bait. I'm going to just put some meat and some pellets up and I'll be ready to rock and roll. It's about 5 minutes, well, 10 minutes to go, so it gives me a few minutes to do it. So I'll speak to you at the start of the match and let's see how I get on.
Okay, match starting. I'm going to put a couple of little balls of ground meat in with chopped worm and caster. Just starting on a worm. It might be a bit early to start on the worm, but I'm going to try in case there's an opportunity of a fish there. Switch the maggot quickly, I think. A double maggot. You hear me?
That was the nibble on the end of one maggot, so we're going to put another one in.
I'm going to go for the small one. Small chub. More bleak. Hope you can see me. right. It was a cast, I'd put a cast on here. Just bumped a fish. More troubles. I'm a caster, single caster. Try double maggot. small chublets. Yes. Trying to cast her, see what happens. Back on a maggot. could be blowing against the wind here, because I think we need some bigger fish today.
In your book.
Big fish, like my mate said. Thank you.
Right. I'm going to go for the bigger hook, bigger float. Days. In the bottom. Okay, I've gone on the feeder. I've had two small chub, only small ones, and I missed two bites on the meat. I don't know whether they're chub or barbel. Keep your fingers crossed. The inside died a death, so I'm still feeding it. Put a meat on and sup a couple of maggots, and the maggots got sucked. So I'm just going to try maggot on this hole now. afraid it's a waiting game, this. Probably small chub, because the ones have had about that big. Although they're proper, not, you know, drop back bites. Very big branch at the at the line then. So what I'm doing is putting a punch on. Thread the meat in on a baiting needle, just up the line, and a couple of maggots. So if the meat comes up, I've still got a maggot on the hook. It's a bit of a combination then, see? We've got fish meal and meat and some maggots in it. In an open-ended feeder. Bow in the line. Just wait for that tip to drop bounce back. I'll come back to you if I get any. Okay, lads, there's an hour to go now. Been pretty slow. I had a couple more on the float, had a couple of perch, so he's had a barbel above me, I know that, and a two chub, I think. I've had two small chub out there, three or four perch on the inside, and some bits, that's about it. So, one meant to be today, by the look of it. Had a nice roach as well on the float. I just put the feeder on the inside for the moment. Just, you know, I don't know where this water's coming up or getting more dirtier. Putting the fish off a little bit. I haven't heard of any weights, so, well, nobody's been along, so I don't know. Well, she's feeding on the inside now, Bubby. I missed a couple of bites on that feeder. Oh, proper dropbacks, but no, I didn't connect to them. Okay, I'll carry on now. So if anything happens exciting, I'll let you know. Okay, somebody eventually come along just now, and he said it's not fishing well. His best he's heard of is 3 barbel. So I've lost three perch on the inside. I didn't want to tell you that, but I don't know what it's cost me. I don't know. I doubt it. I expect they got some bigger weights below me though. So I haven't fished well. I haven't fished well at all. All right, I'll crack on. Okay, well, match is over. I just had a couple of little fish at the end, but not a lot to show to home about. See what the weights are now. It's just coming on.
All
right, a little bit faster. 12. 13. You got that?
No. 14. Have you?
No. I could have. I've had a few on the bloody hook. Never mind. Yeah, 6:14. The lad above me, he had a pike, he won the barbel, his old. He's only weighing 2 pound hot. Well, I haven't fished well. 12 pounds of top weight so far in this zone. But I guess peg 20 at the end, the end one, 200 I should say, I'll probably have that. Right, okay, well, there's another one. Put it down to experience, as I say. Funny place, Bridgnorth, isn't it? Okay, well, anyway, thanks for watching, and see you on the next one. When's the next one now? Probably, next week, I think. Back to Evesham, might be. Okay, thanks for watching.